I love Rushmore. Of the endlessly varied and vibrant shorts and features that Wes Anderson has brought to life, Rushmore is, and I think will always remain, the film of his that I recommend to everyone. Although it is a series of movements which has become a calling card for his work, it is in Rushmore that Wes first perfected the maladjusted, asynchronous dance steps between two or more wounded hearts lashing out and latching on to one another. It is perhaps the greatest entry into the coming-of-age cinema that there has ever been. Or if not its greatest, at the very least, it is its most honest. And never has there been a more penetrating lens to experience the coming-of-age through than those of Max Fisher, as he plummets, and soars again through the rapturous ellipses of disenchantment that punctuated each of our adolescence. Wes's use of colors to suggest and then accentuate not only moods but entire character arcs is as brilliant as the colors themselves. The entirety of Rushmore can be communicated simply as a sequence of colors, combining, replacing one another, and then reappearing as the characters grow. And I don't think a film could make this any more clear than by literally color-coding title cards for the beginning of each chapter. With the prologue beginning in blue, Max is profoundly alone. It isn't until the first chapter in which he meets Rosemary that we're ushered in by the color of red. His intense love of Rushmore and the attachment he feels towards it will soon become projected onto Miss Cross. As we enter the second act of the film, we're welcomed by green. What begins as a period of growth and the galvanization of his new friendships ends in a tailspin of envy between Max and Herman, bringing us back to blue for the third act, emphasizing Max, Herman, and Rosemary's loneliness and the subconscious existential panic they're all wrestling with, then back to red, and so on and so forth. As Max's wardrobe and surroundings slowly begin to supplement their blues for greens and complement their reds with pinks, oranges, and browns, the insecurity and the unceasing pain from the loss of his mother finally begins to ebb, allowing cheerfulness, compassion, and most importantly, growth to take their place. What I think helps Rushmore beam so brilliantly amongst its fellow coming-of-age royalty, though, is that our protagonist is never the sole object of this growth. It is just as much Rosemary's journey to overcome her self-imposed solitude as a grieving widow, or Herman's struggle to combat his visceral trauma and the decay and dissatisfaction it allowed to eventually surround him. Rather than only blocking out scenes to paint Max as dejected and alone, rather than only framing shots to emphasize Max's lack of power or maturity relative to the characters he's sharing his scenes with, Wes regularly exchanges the upper hand between his adult and adolescent characters. And with the film's closing shots, with every stage and walk of life coalescing into a single panoramic portrait, Anderson affirms us of what a lot of coming-of-age films just don't seem to get, and that is where we're coming to isn't a place. Of age has never been a static destination. Rather, it is a point in a cycle that doesn't care how smart or how rich or how stable or how old we are. And it lets us know that we've all been crashing and spinning out on the same track. The adults were just on a different lap than us. Glory does fade, but it also returns. And I love that. Thanks, Wes. Thanks, Owen. Hey, thanks for watching. Big thank you to my patrons for making this video possible, especially these guys, and a very special thank you to Aaron Reyes, Alexi Aro Olavi, Avid, Blake Denby, Brady Kramer, Rand Muffin, Brian Phillips, Caleb Young, Charles J. Boyle, Chase Epsi, Denian, Dr. Chike, Elemantics, Elena Lagerman, Eli Zellers, Gavin Miller, Hoshin, Ibsher, Jacob New, Jacob Helgren, Jan Seiberg, Joe Betts, John Mabs, Jordan Carter, Joshua Fogelson, Killer Space, Lloyd, Longhune, Luigi Murray, Marwan Mohammed, Mason W., Max Clark, Michelle Wen, Mohammed El-Zafri, Nick Bell, Nick Trupiano, Robert Whaley, Rory Strickler, Shane Vino, Straffin Nathan, Travis Osborne, Tristan Marino, William Cole, Jakob Duez, and Zion George. Let me know what you thought about what I thought down below, and make sure to subscribe. Love you, love you, love you. Have a good night.